As an extension soil fertility specialist, I use soil testing for multiple purposes. For example, in a project funded by AFRECT, in which we evaluated nitrogen sources and application timing on tile drainage, we collected soil samples before application, during the growing season, and after harvest, in order to ensure that we were conducting our study properly and to better understand our results. Taking a soil sample is not complicated, but it is important to do it correctly. Keep in mind that the objective is to have a sample that is representative of the area that you want soil test results for. A standard soil series soil test typically reports on the soil texture, percent of organic matter, pH, phosphorus, and potassium levels. This test and the interpretation of the test results are calibrated for the top 6 inches of soil, the typical plow depth. So it isn't a good idea to scrape off the soil surface or go deeper than the 6 inches. There are other measurements that can call for a deeper sample, such as for nitrogen analysis. But for most purposes, you want to stick to the 6 inches. Another thing to consider for obtaining a representative sample is having the entire 6-inch sampling depth represented equally in the sample. A soil probe is designed to take an equal amount of soil to the depth to which it is intended. If you don't have a probe available, a trowel or shallow will do, but you need to make sure that you obtain an equal amount of soil for the entire 6 inches that you are sampling. Simply sticking the shovel in about 6 inches and scooping out the soil will overrepresent the top layer of the soil and underrepresent the lower layers. A better way to get a good sample is to dig a small hole and then take a slice from the side of the hole. Some soil properties can vary widely in a short distance, so it is important to take multiple samples from different spots in the area you are testing. This way, the results you get will be a representative average of the area. For a small garden or lawn, you want to take at least 4 samples. For larger areas, we recommend at least 8 samples spaced out equally. For samples taken from farm fields, make sure that you don't overrepresent row positions, which can result in a biased sample. Some of the cores should be directly from the row, some halfway between the row, and others in intermediates between the row and the middle. For some nutrients, such as potassium, the time of the year when the samples are collected can influence the results. To more easily compare previous results, it is best to take samples at approximately the same time of the year. For example, if you normally collect samples in late fall, it is a good idea to take future samples in the late fall as well. If you own the land you farm, we recommend collecting soil samples every 4 years to check the fertility status. In more intense cropping systems, where there are multiple harvests each year, or where the crop extracts large amounts of nutrients, more frequent sampling, such as every other year, might be a better option. Once all your cores are collected in a bucket, you should break up any clumps and mix the soil thoroughly to aggregate the sample. For some types of analysis, it is important to dry your sample, but this is not critical if you are only conducting a standard series analysis. The last step is simply pour your mixed sample into a sample bag with a clear label that describes the location of the sample so it can be shipped off to the test lab. Sign up for Minnesota Crop News email alerts on the latest in research updates and current growing conditions.